That's what I've heard. And let's not forget the Japanese. They had one message.
Please come to see us.
Oh, you have a message as well.
Yes. We are champion. Two.
Okay, so two messages.
Yeah, that's right. Where was volleyball invented?
Versus Japan. Well played, Japan. You can sing your song now.
We are the champion.
James McConey, CGW News.
Referee. So here we go, the second women's semi-final. Awaiting in the final is Jantine van der Vlist and Sophie van Gestel. Van Gestel, an Olympian from London in 2012. Still only 24 years of age, so a long career still ahead of her. And to reinforce how tight the semi-final could be, this went down to a deciding set in Mount Maunganui last weekend with the Dutch pair winning 15-13, very tight. Here we go, second semi-final, Japanese to serve first. Great rally to start the match, Richard.
That is an example of how the Japanese are going to be in this game. It's suddenly got a lot hotter on the sand and it's heating up out there. Those boys at the Mount Roskill Fire Station might be needed to cool it down because these players are going to heat it up out there.
It was a very warm day in Auckland yesterday, 27, 28 degrees. I must remind you too, that's the air temperature. It can get a lot hotter on the surface.
Yeah, so we measured the sand, a metre above the sand, yesterday just after 2 o'clock and it was 44.
That's incredible, isn't it? 44 degrees. I mean, that raises the possibility do players get burnt feet on really hot sand?
Indeed. Indeed, you saw again the Japanese ninja beach volleyball player Murakami in the backcourt, just reading where the ball's going and getting underneath it. But Ishii couldn't convert, and that time the high line was good enough to beat Murakami. Oh, the ace serve that time. There's a good one landing on the baseline. You won't see that error too much in the Japanese. The Japanese that time, tough serving from the Dutch and they come back into the game.
Very nice play from Murakami. Very aware that there is going to be space behind. Can't really defend the entire court, can you, with just two players? So there's always going to be space. Ishii serving. Yeah, power at the net again. We're seeing a very similar style of beach volleyball, aren't we, to the first semi-final?
Yeah, and you'll see the countries all develop their own styles of the game. So the Dutch, all their players and all their programs, very similar. And also the same for the Japanese. It's like a physical trait each country has, and they play that certain way.
Again, that's the second time in a row we've seen the Murakami execute that shot with some precision.
Yeah, it's a beautiful length, high rainbow to the baseline. with the sand heating up, that's what the Japanese will do. They're going to try and run these Dutch rounds so they don't get to the net to play their power game.
Oh, Murakami's been the star of this set so far. Great defense on that occasion.
Yeah, she just gets into position, and when she touches it, she controls it beautifully to her partner every time. So she's made the dive and dig, but it's straight to her partner. And then the high roll shot down the line catches Cinema out of position.
So let's go back to that point about the hot sand, Richard. I mean, how much of a concern is it about for players? I mean, it can be distracting. How do they deal with it?
So these guys play pretty much weekly for 6 months of the year on some of the hottest sand beaches in the world. So they've conditioned, they train in it. Often they wear sand socks. They don't actually, when the sand's played on, it gets churned over quite a bit, so it doesn't heat up like it does if you're walking along the beach. It's more the temperature up just above the sand playing in those humid, sandy conditions. And often if it gets too hot, when you're in Brazil and Southern Asia, you're playing on, it's 40 degrees and they water the courts. We haven't had to do that here yet.
Well, the first service error, this time to Ishii.
Angle roll shot again is a good one from Murakami.
So this is tight, this one, isn't it? 7 apiece. Really no quarter given by either combination.
Yep, two different styles meeting on the sands of Auckland.
There's the play. That's where Cinema wants the serve to go. Just going wide. Oh, it's gone actually to the Dutch. Yeah. That's unlucky for the Japanese combination.
Yeah, so what's happened is the referee has judged the ball's been hit into the net and didn't actually hit the block. And looking on that replay, that's exactly what happened.
The official's getting that one spot on. Well, they haven't capitalised though.
Yeah, as I always say, sometimes the ball always knows.
Well, it's tight this one, isn't it? 8 apiece. And this was tight, this match, last week in Mount Maunganui as well. Good rivalry between these two combinations. That was long.
And a tough float serve just out the back. But you can see the Japanese are going after their serve. They're prepared to miss a few to actually put the pressure on the tall Dutch side.
Nicely done by Murakami again. She's got great beach volleyball IQ, hasn't she?
Yep. She sees space. She looks like she's got time. There's the Japanese beach ninja. Goes back to serve. She's got that ball. Look at her fly around the court. And the scramble's great.
How about that, Richard? That was just class.
Indeed. Watch it. What's the slow-mo we're going to get on this replay? She looked like Superwoman flying across the court full strength. Digs it up in her partner. Mickey Ishii was able to play a knuckle shot off the big block. I'm pretty happy about it.
Fantastic play from the Japanese combination.
Thank you.
It's a good change-up. Nice scrambling from the Japanese pair, but that was a well-executed little drop shot over the top.
Yeah, that, what they call the baby cut, just a little one to keep Murakami guessing. But again, she's still got a piece of it. That's the pressure for the Dutch at the moment. And see, this Dutch team not hitting as many hard balls.
Well, a technical timeout has come in this first set, and it's the Japanese pair who are in front, 11 points to 10. Be a brave person to pick a winner from this one.
Indeed, that's actually one of the sports we don't have betting on here in New Zealand yet, not part of the TAB in our country. A bit of a discussion going on whether we should, because the World Beach Volleyball Tour is very big with a lot of money in it. And TAB's been fantastic at creating opportunities for sports, generating some income for their sport.
Yes, they sure have.
And obviously looking at the treatment of the players going on. Obviously the international teams are all professional athletes. Our top New Zealand players, semi-professional. Our number one New Zealand men's team and women's teams do hold jobs, trying to pay the bills to get on the world tour. So we're always looking for more sponsorship and partners to look after them. There's a very good chance the boys will be in Rio and qualify out of the Olympic qualification in June in Australia after winning the Oceania Champs just a couple of months ago, beating up on Australia. And they're obviously one of the big threats. Also with Kazakhstan, Japan, Thailand, Indonesia, China. All those countries will be battling out in the Olympic qualification in June in Australia. As they check the servers, it's Miki Ishii. Serving after the technical timeout.
Got it again. Well, they're just defying their height disparity at the moment, Ishii and Murakami. And now they've got a 2-point lead.
Focus for Miki Ishii. She knows she's serving a weapon out there. Wants to hit her targets.
So quick with her reactions. Ishii that time, but couldn't get the control on it.
Yeah, the power spike from Bruckman. Too much for Miki Ishii, but she got her hands on it. Watch it drop off the net. Watch how fast the ball comes to her.
She tried to use the pace of the ball, didn't she, to maneuver it to her teammate. There was too much power on that one. And there's an ace. So that 2-point margin has just evaporated. Great serve, right on the line too. Judged to perfection from Sinema. Bruckman this time. That's three consecutive points now to Bruckman and Sinema from the Netherlands.
Yeah, big power run, three big powerful plays. Suddenly they've jumped in front after falling behind.
These are important points. Bruckman this time. Killing it off, and that's four in a row, Richard.
Yeah, suddenly the Dutch have just had a lightning bolt and gone power, power, power. And suddenly on the serve, it's created the pressure for the Japanese. They haven't been out of sight out.
Not surprising we're seeing the Japanese pair call a timeout here too to talk things over. They want to stop the rot, slow the thing down, and reassess how to take the power out of the Dutch players that have managed to do so successfully in the early part of the set.
Yeah, so Sinema in the white glasses has come back and served tougher and just, right, I'm going to hit the ball anymore. No more stuff, cut and roll shots.
They'll be keen to keep it going. Very keen.
So the Japanese will just take a timeout. It's the first time they've probably lost 4 points in a row for this match. So they'll take a wee break. Try and break the rhythm of the Dutch.
It's a great day to enjoy beach volleyball.
Yeah, the crowd slowly building. You still get in. You can get door sales if you want to come down if you're in Auckland. We're seeing the top beach volleyballers. Of course, our New Zealand number one men's team up next in the semi-final. Sam O'Day and Mike Watson at what will be a thrilling semi.
Yes, indeed. We're seeing O'Day and Watson. Another New Zealand combination in the doubles as well. And the men's. Clever play again, isn't it, from these two?
Yeah, they control the ball and wait for their opportunity, and then a little cut shot from Mickey Ishii. She got it right that time. She missed a couple of valuable opportunities. She's worked out where she wants to play that ball with those softer baby cut shots.
Yes, we've got the men's semi-finals coming up after midday.
With a little cut shot, but the full extended dig from Brachman kept the ball alive and on the net. There you see the power and heat, and the Dutch get close to the net. The Japanese knew they had a chance then, couldn't convert.
Yes, indeed. Great at this Japanese pair of boys, asking your opponents to play one more rally, one more shot. Brachman. Oh, that's a shocker.
Yeah, she's, again, you can see the Dutch are still trying to put a lot of pressure on their serve as well, because that's such a critical part of the game to get the players out of their normal attacking formation.
Radar askew that time. Now, Ishii. Ishii, how does she get a hand on it? I know she didn't win the point.
She'll actually be pretty frustrated there, because the mistake from the Dutch came from the set over the net. But the long arm of Cinema, watch this, one-handed block above the net. Great play by her. She's pretty happy knowing that was a lucky play for the Dutch, but keeps the two-point break.
Well, it's back to one again. Brachman, for all her good work in the last point, undoes it in this one. In fact, that was Cinema, wasn't it? 16-15. They've still got a one-point lead, though, in the race to 21 in this first set. Second women's semi. Remember, the winner of this match through to play Van der Vlist and Van Gestel in the final from Holland. So are we going to see a third Japanese-Netherlands battle today to conclude the tournament, or are we going to see an all-Dutch affair in the final? That's the question.
Yeah, the huge Japanese crowd hiding in the back stands will be hoping Japan can get through to that gold medal match of the New Zealand Open.
Well, total confusion that time between Ishii and Murakami.
A very rare passing error from the Japanese. The communication out. The husband and wife, they call it. Down the middle perfectly.
It's yours. No, it's yours.
Noah.
Is in just.
Great swing. Little line judge. Fantastic call. Thought it was going out, then changed his call in.
How old is that line judge?
He's 11.
Fantastic.
He won the silver medal, the under 15 age group championships at Mount Maunganui a few weeks ago. Super keen beach volleyballer.
Oh. No, just running out of sand there. Was it Ishii? 19-16. Brachman Cinema now getting close, Richard. They've got this nice little three-point buffer down the stretch. Just repeating what those men's semi-finals are coming up. We've got O'Day and Watson. That's Sam O'Day and Mike Watson up against Rennie Carper and Morgan Seymour in semi-final number one. And in semi-final number two later, it's going to be Shiratori and Hasegawa of Japan up against Mackenzie of the USA and Ben O'Day of New Zealand.
Chance again for the Dutch. It's at the net. Here comes the power.
They've got the point now. They're on set point. Brachman and Cinema. Well, this is disappointing for Ishii and Murakami. They've done all this good work up until about the last maybe 5 to 10 minutes. 5 minutes maybe, Richard, and it's just slipped away from her. Set point.
like the Dutch just picked up their game, more pressure on stuff like that serve, and the scramble's great for the Japanese.
Oh, brilliant play. They've got a run out of time, though, and there it is. Bruckman and Cinema have got the first set. They had to work hard to get it, though. But in the end, that margin of 5 points, pretty comfortable on the scoreboard. Perhaps the method getting there, not so. 21-16, though, is set number one to Bruckman and Cinema.
Amazing how the power game blew out that first set for Bruckman and Cinema. But as you can see, Ishimiki, the big serve, actually, that's a key part. The change pressure of the serve from the Dutch broke the Japanese to get some easy points. And the scramble from the Japanese, you can see them giving everything. But in the end, the Dutch too big, too powerful, too strong at the net when it counted.
So Bruckman and Cinema will be pleased. Cinema here, 5'11", 23 years of age. Bruckman, 24. 5'11 as well. Both seasoned beach volleyballers around the world. See, Bruckman, very good junior, wasn't she? Second at the World Championships under 19s. Third at the under 21 World Championships when she was of that age. And European under 23 champion as well.
And the best finish at the Open, graded fifth on a World Tour event as well. So that's with the best beach volleyballers in the world that are all full-time athletes. They play between 10 and 15 events on the World Tour, all through Europe, Asia, and the Americas. Culminating in the World Tour Finals, and every 2 years a World Championship, and obviously the Olympic Games.
The challenge now for Ishii Murakami. How can they come back here? How can they continue to take out that power game that Bruckman and Cinema managed to implement successfully towards the tail of that first set?
They just need to take their opportunities. They had a few chances, didn't convert. Every time they get a chance, they've got to make it count. They do create enough pressure by the style of play, and they do scramble brilliantly.
It's going to be a point to the Japanese.
Yeah, so that rule there was a double contact called on the defensive play by the Dutch. When the ball's not hard driven, so you saw Murakami didn't hit it too hard. There was a roll shot to the back corner. When you play it with your fingers, a very technical rule, it must be perfect. The referee, Tushra, deemed it was a double contact.
Oh, this is superb.
The scramble.
Well, that's unlucky, isn't it? Hard luck for the Japanese pair.
It is hard luck, but they had the opportunity early in that play to go to 2-0, couldn't convert, and the Dutch scrambled the lucky play off the top of the tape, not even jumping. So in trouble, I'll just get it in, and it's a kill shot they call it, the game of beach volleyball.
Yes, it was. That was unlucky, wasn't it? The Japanese had the opportunity, you said. They had plenty of open court. A nail there, but instead they went down the line, and now the Japanese have got their point. Maybe a bit of justice there. So 2 points to one early on in the second set. First set went to Bruckman Cinema by 21-16.
Oh, a huge error that time for Bruckman. She's hit that way out the back. Very surprising shot. Didn't quite make position. Japan get a 2-point advantage early again in the second set.
Oh. Well, those errors. 3-1 up, 4-1, possibly. They've blown the opportunity, and now Bruckman Cinema got the serve back. It's nicely done by Murakami.
Yeah, lovely cut shot. So when she gets to the net, the Dutch keep the block at the net, which means there's always some open sand. Watch it go up, As she goes to jump, she'll have a quick look, see the space. The tactic of the Dutch at the moment to block the cross power and run down the shot down the line. So the Japanese have recognised this and are playing the soft shot over the block cross court.
Murakami's been playing well.
That time a little touch off the block of the Japanese, so she did hit it hard and it looked like it went out, but a little small touch off the hands of Miki Ishii. It's called touching out.
Well, I guess you got to commit either way, don't you? It's pretty tough to hope that the spike will drift out of court on most occasions. That's beautifully killed off that time by Blackman.
So you saw the Dutch that time, instead of blocking at the net, drop off the net, creating a tougher shot for the Japanese, which made the defensive play easier for the Dutch, and the conversion came.
And yes, the height and wingspan into effect on full display that time from Sinema.
Yeah, the big arm well above the top of the net created the block.
Yes, Ishii kills it off.
So again, you saw the tactic from the Dutch to get off the net and scramble, and they made a good play in the pass to the net. Gives a chance to Sinema to win it, but too close, and Miki Ishii wise enough to stay and made the play when she had to.
Another point to Japan. Take the lead now, 6-5.
Let's have a wee discussion with the ref. The pass went into the net, and if it touches the red and white stick known as the aerial, the ball's considered out. And that's what's happened there on that play. Called by Des Kerikeri, the down ref, the second ref. Job to look after the net. Another error from a tough serve for the Dutch.
It's a clever play again from Japanese pair, combining well as a team. Just saw that one communication error in the first set from them. Yes! Murakami with another point. They're on a bit of a roll here. That's 4 points in a row, Richard.
Indeed, Japanese, big roll, the game of momentum out there right now. No problem reading the Dutch. The Dutch are feeling the heat out there.
Yeah, they've called a timeout.
What if you get some of those firemen in to cool down the court? Yesterday we had the call out from the fire service. Someone in the gym accidentally set off an alarm. Oh. And we had to evacuate the whole venue.
Gee whiz. Oh, great day for any outside activity. Points to 5 in the second set. Well, that's part of the sport, isn't it? If you're not covered in sand at some point during a game, you're not throwing your body around enough, are you, Richard?
Indeed. It's funny discussion about the female uniforms. They actually want to play less because the sand gets everywhere. And so they like the uniforms to be tight, not let the sand in anywhere.
Got it again. I was about to say whether we're going to see whether the timeout is going to get these Dutch players just to focus things up. Things going again, and the Japanese continue to set the standards in the second set.
Yeah, the serve reception of the Dutch just off the mark at the moment, and therefore the set is going too close to the net. And even Miki Ishii at only 5'8", scoring points at the net right now.
brilliant play again. They've just got this great awareness of where the open court is. The subtleties of beach volleyball on display.
Yeah, spectacular defense again. On the sand every time. It's little Murayami, and then the cut shot high over the big block scores the point.
To see that point replay.
Indeed.
I think Stefan Tuchel actually accidentally blew his whistle there, did he?
Yeah, I think he thought it was a net touch, but it was actually the ball that hit to the top of the tape. Japanese won't be happy about that because they made the defensive play. It was actually a chance for Japan to score another point. And the Dutch would be very happy. So, yeah, Stefan just jumped the gun a wee bit.
And it's paid off. Kind of had the feeling that point would go that way.
And you saw the Dutch game that they want to be doing. They want to get the ball nice and close and high to the net so they can go up and hit the ball hard and steep, taking the defensive player out of the game.
Service error.
Yeah, Cinema. She's just feeling a bit grumpy at the moment on the court. She's sort of hit that last ball very hard in anger because she's not quite making her pass on the serve receive. You'll see the serve go at her.
Nice variety that time from Cinema.
Yeah.
Maybe playing the Japanese at their own game might be a nice tactic.
Well, you saw her get a good pass, so it was close enough to the net for a partner to hand set her, nice and high and close to the net. And then the knuckle shot over top of the blocks. Easy when they're close to the net. Scrambles brilliant from Bruckman.
Yeah, it didn't count in the end as Murakami dealt one away to the open court.
Big swing. Great play from the Japanese scrambling. Then the power spot just to keep the Dutch there. That'll keep the blocker at the net. Obviously, if you don't hit the ball hard, the blocker looks to drop off the net to scramble for those shot plays. So the power was great.
Oh, Cinema switched on to return the serve there.
Yeah, tough serve again from the Japanese. That's what they do very well. And it's just floating through the air.
Bit of heat on that one.
Yep, and that's the Dutch game. If they're hitting the ball hard all the time, they're always hard to defend. As we go to the technical timeout, 13-8, the Japanese with a great lead in the second set. But watch the height of Bruckman. She'll go up, all power. Murakami, the Japanese beach ninja, was there, but couldn't control it.
13-8, first set went to Bruckman and Cinema by 21 points to 16. Winner of this match through to play Jantien van der Vlist and Sophie van Gestel of the Netherlands in the final. And you had a win over Akiko Hasegawa and Ayumi Kasano, 21-16, 21-13. Still to come today, remember the men's semi-finals. They're on the sand at around an hour's time, 12:20, and then we'll have the finals to conclude play here at the ASB Tennis Centre. I hope you're enjoying coverage of live beach volleyball here on Sky Sport.
Yeah, it's fantastic to have the beach volleyball live on Sky. It's been a while since we've been here and on TV. It's great for our run into the Rio Olympics. As we look to grow the game, we've got thousands of kids playing now across the country, especially in the Bay of Plenty and the North Harbour, that are just getting passionate about this game.
Bruckman and Cinema can't afford service errors. Once you're getting that 5-6 point margin behind, Richard, you are, it's really a big no-no.
Indeed, but they're pushing hard to catch up and making errors doing it. The error again from the Dutch on the set. Akiyoshi knuckles it. Great scramble by Bruckman.
Yeah, that was coming. It was just set up beautifully there for Sinema to put that one away.
And Akiyoshi knows she should have scored then, so I talked about those opportunities. Even though the Japanese are in front, it could change very quickly, and that a missed opportunity. Great defense by Sinema.
Out. No, it's been given to the Japanese. Yes, it was out.
Yeah. Sinema's not happy. She's demonstrating the frustration of her game right now. And it's just long.
Captain, please. Captain. Captain, please. Captain. Yes, it's all right. You're allowed to have a word, but please calm down, okay?
Yeah, but so frustrating. It's the third mistake.
Calm down, yeah? I've got my cards with me as well, so,
yeah,
so that's
here.
Okay? Calm down. The captain is allowed to speak with me.
I'm captain.
Yes, that's why you're here. We see it that way. It's our call.
Yeah, it's okay.
And then we're going to
do it. It's the third mistake in one set.
Well, there we are. There's the call. They were convinced, I think, it just nicked the finger of one of the Japanese players, right?
They're actually going whether it touched the baseline or not, and that's out. Close, but just out. Good call by the officials. Good call by little Dominique Minoida.
She was undecided, wasn't she? Oh, they've got it in the end. Brilliant.
Spectacular play for the Japanese. They're not flustered at all in the situation. That dig there made it look so simple. And then the shot back, power cross court for the Japanese. Caught Bruckman unawares. And Miki Ishii is pretty happy with the partner right there.
Yeah, the dig was superb. Really set up the point beautifully. Big lead here now. Point in the end.
So it actually has gone the way of the Japanese.
It's gone the Japanese, hasn't it? Yeah, so tell us what happened there.
Yeah, the rule of the game is that you can't play the ball on the other side of the net. So you see the ball go high on the net from the set, and the Japanese player's gone down to dig it, but Bruckman's got up and played it. And the question is, did her hand go over our side of the net? And referee Tertia has said yes. The Dutch didn't argue, so obviously correct.
Yes, the Japanese were convinced that was the case as well. Oh. Another one to the Japanese. Just extraordinary play, Richard. I mean, sometimes it's not all about size and power in the Japanese combination are proving that now.
Yeah, I'm convinced the heat's having an effect. The longer the rally goes, the harder it is to run around in the sand and control the ball. And the Japanese are just great at that, and the Dutch are just missing their place.
And the defense from both Ishii and Murakami is just top quality right now.
Another mistake from the set from Bruckman, just too kind of going over the net into the Japanese. Well, Miki Ishii's making a lot of plays in the net from the mistakes of the Dutch.
It's getting hot here in Auckland here on centre court, and the beach volleyball from Ishii and Murakami is just top quality. A 10-point margin, 2 points away from sending this semi-final to a deciding set. Surely this is in the bag. Surely.
The Dutch game that they've been trying to play, but you haven't seen for the last 5 or 6 points. Get the ball high to the net, swing high and hard and deep over the top of the block.
They just haven't set up enough like this, have they?
No,
have they?
The pressure for the Japanese has just been too much at the moment. Cinema goes for the power spike serve, but wide, another error, and there we go. A convincing second set, 10 set points. It's a heat wave out there for the Japanese right now.
Sure is. So set point here to Murakami. Oh, got a good piece of that one, but direction not there. The one of 10 set points saved.
But I'm thinking the Japanese will side out here in the next one or two points and feel very confident going into the third set.
Yeah, momentum is critical, isn't it? And Ishii has got it done for the Japanese pair. They've got it. The second set in convincing fashion, 21-11. We are going to a deciding set in this second women's semi-final.
Yep, so the referee comes down, takes the toss. And the all-important point.
Beautiful, mate. You, Lou.
Which side will they take? Will they serve? Will they receive?
Okay.
It's going to be the Dutch who'll receive. So this deciding set to 15 points. Not to 21, to 15. Got to win by a margin of two.
And they'll change ends every 5 points. And this is where the game really heats up. It's a race to 15.
This is the second time in a week these two combinations have met each other. The last occasion in Mount Maunganui, and that also went to a deciding set. And 15-13 was the final score to
the Dutch.
Yes.
So Japanese scramble. They play a great game, and it was last weekend. It was actually very windy on the mount, which makes it another unique experience on the beach. Here we're in a sheltered hot oven. It'll just be who can actually last the longest and make the most plays under pressure.
It's a great day to watch beach volleyball here at the ASB Tennis Centre here in Auckland.
Of course, we're looking to grow this game and take these sorts of venues down to the South Island as well. There's some great development programs happening in Christchurch and also Nelson, where there are fantastic kids coming through. So we now can take beach volleyball into these sorts of centres to try and get a crowd and more sponsorship and marketing behind it. And also our young kids on the line scoring, it gives them something to aim for. And of course it's an Olympic sport, so a great opportunity. When New Zealand's not quite there yet, the Olympics were so close. We've been very close for the last 16 years. Can we crack it for Rio in 2016?
So here we go, deciding set in the second semi-final. Every point critical now, and the Dutch have got the first one, looking to bounce back from a horror second set.
Yeah, they actually same sort of mistake. Japan had an opportunity I talked about earlier. They had one there, couldn't convert.
Mistakes like that are not what's needed from Cinema.
Yeah, you'd argue a very poor mistake at the start of the third set. Looking for a tough serve, but it wasn't even close.
So it's going to be Megumi Murakami. The race to 15 in this deciding set. Superb again from Ishii at the net.
Yeah, she certainly got a big jump. She gets high enough to compete with the 5'11 Cinema. But again, the bump setting of Bruckman's just a little bit close. And Cinema is getting up, knuckles it, but not through the big block of Ishii.
Ishii is giving up 3 centimetres, or 3 inches to her opponent, rather. So she's actually jumping on a trampoline. You put a trampoline under the sand there somewhere, have you, Richard?
Unfortunately, they wouldn't let us do that. Nothing in between these two sides. Who's going to score the point for the court end switch?
Going to get that one back.
Scramble's fantastic. Great play by both sides. And Sinema shows how much they want it.
And there's some pretty passionate supporters. Having a look at this. 3 points to 2. Nice changing courts after every 5 points. Cut and thrust of a deciding set here. Ishii to serve. Oh, that's one service error each now. Three apiece. Going to get that again, maneuvering the ball nicely to the edges of the court.
Yeah, looking for the wide shot, trying to make the big tall Dutch players move around the court, forces their control. They couldn't control it at all that time.
Oh dear, that's the second service error we've seen from Kami now and Ishii. Yes, nicely disguised this time. Ishii gets the job done.
The baby cut shot. Beautiful control because it was a tough serve from Sinema. You'll see the Dutch go with their tough jump serve. Beautiful up from Mickey Ishii, and Ishii, look at that, little baby lion. The Dutch, too short.
Plenty of open sand at the front that time. Oh, brilliantly done by Murakami.
Yeah, the Japanese with a bit of miscommunication. The Dutch have called a timeout in frustration. But Murakami, the Japanese beach ninja, saw the defense of the Dutch and hit it down the middle of them. The perfect shot when you're not sure, hit between the two players. Well read again.
Well, these two now trail by 2 points. First time we've seen in this deciding set a margin of greater than 1 point.
It's critical not to let any momentum swings get too big. When the race to 15's on, they're already a third of the way through the set. The teams will cool off, get ready to roll. It's going to be a humdinger finish in the hot sands of the ASB Tennis Center.
You get the feeling that Ishii Murakami standards have just raised a little bit and they've maintained at that level, haven't they? And so far, Brachman Sinema unable to put them off their stride, rattle them.
No, they actually are making a lot of mistakes themselves. So.
So the question is, can these two just continue to stay composed? They're very experienced players, both of them age 30. Use considerable cork craft and, well, sandcraft maybe to get the job done here. And the wingspan of Sinema on display there. It's going to be Brachman to serve. Oh dear, oh dear.
And Brachman, too much muscle on that one.
Errors again proving costly in this third set.
Great block. Splendid rally, ended by Murakami.
He's sensational play. What a great block by Miki Eshi, but the Dutch, they did it brilliantly with a dig in the scramble, and then the kill from the Japanese beach ninja, Murakami, just sees the space brilliantly. He has this block, 6 centimeter difference. But then watch this, Murakami, bang, cross court, and
big point that one. It's given the Japanese a 3-point lead now. It's been eliminated to 2.
Cinemark got close enough to net, just hit hard and deep.
Well, well. Race to 15 in this deciding set. The winner through to play Jantien van der Vlist and Sophie van Gestel. The Netherlands in the final. It's going to drift wide. It is. That's good. Gutsy. Never give up play there from that pair.
Yeah, the Dutch have fought back on 2 big points to keep in this game.
They have. It was 8-5 a minute ago, remember? And now it's just a single point in it again. Points to 7. Timeout, in fact, these two.
Good chance for the Japanese just to reflect, catch their breath, make sure they get back into their rhythm of what they were doing before. You just sense the Dutch have lifted, more assertive, more aggressive at the net, and actually made a couple of great defensive plays.
Well, a 3-point margin down to 1. Very tight. Very tight. Tighter than a taxman's purse, maybe. What worse places to be than right at the tennis centre here today, watching some top quality beach volleyball. Hope you're enjoying the coverage. We've got the men's semi-finals still to come, remember, and the finals later, and the women's and the men's too. So second match of 6 on Sky Sport today. We're enjoying at the moment, and it's a beauty, this one.
With the dig.
Well executed. Just drifting that one over.
That time, Brachman with the dig in backcourt was able to play the high line shot for the winner. The Japanese just lost their side out game for a few points in a row, and suddenly it's 8-all with the race to 15.
This is a very fine comeback from Brachman and Sinema. Won the last 3 points in a row. Well left. From Ishii.
Cinema can't believe it. She had a great roll on, went for another tough serve and missed.
Ishii and Murakami. Every decision they make now critical. Great play from Brachman, but she's overcooked it.
Yeah, great play by Brachman. She's made 3 defensive digs, kept them in the play. The Japanese struggling to side out. But that time, Brachman misses long. Great shot. You'll see him get down in the sand, get up fast. High line. It's too big.
Oh, dear. Sinema. Errors are starting to mount against Brachman and Sinema now.
Yeah, they got rid of him at the beginning of the set. That one there is critical. 11-8.
Well, that 3-point margin they wiped out a moment ago is now back out to 3. Make that margin 4 now. This is starting to look very good for Ishii and Murakami.
Indeed, 12-8, there'll be a court switch. Might be the break the Dutch need. Another error from Sinema. She won't be happy. The frustration. Oh, slaps her partner's hand pretty hard.
So they'll be wondering how this has gone wrong. They were looking in control at 21-16 after that first game. And since then, it's really been one-way traffic. Oh, superb play again from Ishii this time. They're a great combination, this pair.
Yeah, their team play is extraordinary. They make a dig, they get the ball to each other and control it, and then make a play, take the opportunities when they can. That time, Ishii off the block beautifully.
Just 2 points away from victory now. Oh, yes. Brachmann this time.
The second ball played just to break the defense down. Worked beautifully for the Dutch. Pass is tight. Brachmann had no real option but to hit it. They hit it perfectly.
Now prolongs this match just a little bit longer. Continues to ask Ishii and Murakami to earn these last 2 points, but she can't afford a service error, Brachmann. Brilliant block at the net, Sinema that time. That was A1.
That's what they need. They need a few more of them. But the pressure is on. Miki Ishii, the tactics changed to go away from the Japanese beach ninja of Murakami. The services will be on Ishii. What play is she going to come up with?
Oh, this time it's in. She's got that one right, Murakami.
Mistake, I think, from the Dutch. The serve's gone on the Japanese beach ninja, Murakami, and suddenly we've got match point, four of them for the Japanese.
Murakami has the opportunity here to close this match out, 14-10, match point. And there it is, a comeback victory for Megumi Murakami and Miki Ishii. They dropped the first set 16-21, but they have come back magnificently to win the second 21-11 and to win the third by 15-10 to make it through to the final. Murakami and Ishii, a great performance, and they'll take on Jantien van der Vlist and Sophie van Gestel in the final. That pair from the Netherlands. Good match, this one.
Fantastic match, and you see two different styles of beach volleyball. Today, the Dutch weren't good enough to control it, and the heat, the sand of the ASB Tennis Centre was too much for them. And the control of the Japanese, fantastic scrambling play. This time, the little people win.
Yes, great variety and good play from the Japanese pair, manoeuvring the ball to the open court and keep their opponents on the run. So, fabulous effort. So there is confirmation of the women's final. It's going to be van der Vlist and van Gestel of the Netherlands up against Japan's Ishii and Murakami. And that will be the final. The interesting contrast of styles in the final between the Dutch and the Japanese pair. Right, stand by though in about half an hour. Hope you can rejoin us. We'll have the men's semi-finals coming up in about half an hour here on Sky Sport. We'll be following that. Will be the women's final and then the men's final here from the ASB Tennis Centre here in Auckland. It's grand finals day of the New Zealand Beach Volleyball Open. Straight sets against another Japanese combination. You can see the height difference between them there too, Richard, can't you? 5'11", Sophie van Gestel. And van der Vlist, the same. In fact, she's just a smidgen taller at 6 foot.
Indeed, versus the 5'5", Megumi Murakami, Japanese beach ninja. Can they compete with this world-class Dutch team? Sophie van Gestel serving up the big jumper to start.
Van Gestel, remember, Olympian from the 2012 London Games. She was just 20 at that time. And they just missed the quarterfinals. Sophie Van Gestel and her partner now teaming up with young team Van der Vlist. Still putting that one away, but she's got it on the line. So fast start made by the Dutch pair.
Yeah, two big serves straight away. Shows the intentions. The Japanese already struggling to side out, but it is on the back of some sensational jump serving.
Touched the net, Van Gestel, so Ishii and Murakami will be pleased to have got a point because that was threatened to be a very quick start.
Yeah, they battled away and just the unlucky net touch from Van der Vlist.
So now we're going to see Murakami with the first serve. Gestel has started like a rocket.
Yep, she certainly has got a rocket on her shoulder. Really putting the pressure on the Japanese to be super perfect with their touches. Van der Vlist, what type of serve is she going to use?
Van Gestel with the stop, and then she put it away beautifully.
Yeah, the pressure at the moment on little Murakami. She's just struggling to get into her rhythm, and the Dutch are playing it perfectly. They're getting the ball to the net for the easy side out, or easy point. They're off to a flyer.
This is quality play from this Dutch pair. Wow, they are on the back foot big time, Ishii and Murakami. This is quite a turnaround from how we saw them in their semi-final. Van der Vlist and Van Gestel. Very good start to this final. It's just wide again. No luck at all for this Japanese pair.
No, the pressure's created the errors for the Japanese. And Van Gestel and Van der Vlist will be happy. They had a very definite plan when they started the game, and they've implemented to fly out to 6-1. Japanese won't go away.
Well, they'll fight hard to the bitter end, won't they? Well, they've got the effect that's just been touched by that Japanese pair, so another point to Van der Vlist and Van Gestel. Just clipped the old second finger there.
Yeah, the ring finger.
Yeah. Well, there's an error.
But the start was fast from Van Gestel. You'll see her keep jump serving the whole game. The Japanese now need to make some plays to come back into it.
Dominance continuing here. Scramble at the net's going to end up the Dutch sway.
The other player on the team, but if it's done, the fear was played.
Big lead here for this Netherlands pair. Oh, she's powerful there, isn't she? Van der Vlis that time earns the point. Yeah. 10 points to 3. They are off and running big time.
Yeah, Van der Vlis that time. Strong on the block, knowing that Miami's trying to score points. The set's too tight, gives it no room.
Just long. 10 points to 4 is the score. As the change ends, Richard, how do this Japanese pair get back into this first set?
Well, they could throw sand in the eyes of the Dutch to try and put them off at the moment.
I'd somehow think that might get a bit of a warning from the referee.
No doubt about that.
Everything going Van der Vlis and Van Gestel's way, but how do they do it? What do you think strategically they could do?
They need to make this first pass, and our little Japanese ninja Murakami must start passing perfectly and start sighting out, because every serve's going to her. They've targeted her as the star player. She's run around in the backcourt and does all the work, but they're putting everything on her. So that pass here is putting pressure on, and they're going to struggle to score this point. And that's how the game started, and it's how it's continuing. So she needs to make her first pass to get into this game. Then they've got to go back and serve tough to get the Dutch off their game. You know, 8 points back is a long way, and in this heat, it could sap you to catch up. It's almost worth conserving and trying to get a rhythm in your team going and really focus on taking that second set.
Great serve from Van Gestel. Now she'll put that away. She is just dominating this match.
She is a sensational player, because for 6 foot, 6 foot one, she gets around the backcourt beautifully, and then she can get to the net and swing away. She is world class. That's why she's on the podium almost at the Grand Slam to end the season last year in Austria. And then she's got a big weapon of a jump serve.
She sure has. Remember, she only just missed being a quarterfinalist to Sophie Van Gestel at the last Olympic Games, and you'd have to say, interesting to see how she goes at this year's Olympic Games.
Indeed.
She's got great variety to her play as well. Not all about the power.
No, the subtleness that time, very little what they call a baby cut. Okay, she's been hitting all the balls hard, to the defense expects that, so you're sitting back on your heels. Even the great defensive Japanese player couldn't get under the roll shot. There's her shot at last. She's got a side out.
Well, that's what we saw a lot of in the semi-final by Ishii and Murakami. Errors like that, Richard.
No, the Japanese just have lost their way. They've been overpowered and in a bit of a shock as we go to a technical timeout at 15-6. Probably a welcome timeout for the Japanese.
Need something, don't they? They're just not able to get the ball to where they want to put it, like they were getting in the semi-finals. Able to manoeuvre the ball to the open court. They're not being allowed to, because Van Gestel is getting too many opportunities.
She is. She's creating pressure with her serve, and she's making some great defensive plays, set up by a pretty solid block at the net by Van der Vlis. But it's on the back of a not-so-good pass from the Japanese. Something which is their strength is that they pass super well. And they're just missing at the moment under the pressure of the tough serving from the Dutch pairing. Things changed pretty quickly in this game. We saw them fight back beautifully in the after losing the first set of the first semi-final. So hopefully they can gather their thoughts and get their rhythm going and get into the groove they were in the last game.
Van Gestel has got the tape on her back. Got a support around her waist there. She makes the service error that time. is a welcome free point to the Japanese pair.
Indeed. So Murakami, she'll go back, look for a jump float, probably attack Vandalist.
Vandalist this time puts that away.
But her high line is a good one. So solid, the Dutch team passing and setting is very accurate. Spent hours and hours perfecting the pass and the set, making the offense a lot easier. Murakami makes a play that time, but again her pass was a long way off the net. The set's coming from a long way off the net. Makes it very hard to her to play her game that she can.
Great block. Oh, the scrambling, it's over. Oh, nicely done. Nicely done by the Japanese pair. It was Ishii this time.
That's what the crowd wanted, to get them into the game. They love the spectacular play the Japanese can do. What a scramble by the Dutch. Van Gistel gets it over from a tight angle. A cheeky first ball up from Miki Ishii. And the smiles on the Japanese at last. Can that change the momentum?
A long, long way back. And it's business as usual. Normal service has resumed.
The power from Vandalist through the block this time. Good position from Miki Ishii. She got up there, got her hands above the net, nice and high. But the power from Vandalist put it through the block.
It's beautifully finished by Vandalist this time, getting nice depth on that shot.
Van Gistel, sensational dig in the backcourt. So fast and moves quickly across the sand. For such a tall, lean player.
It's time Murakami. Still fighting hard here.
She's now got three side outs with three different shots, so she's got her brain thinking on where she needs to play. So hopefully she's relaxed and calm and got back into her focus to serve tough and serve receive well. I'm thinking they're going to be a lot closer in the second set.
Yes, it's maintained itself at this 7 to 8 point margin for a while now. Superb block. Smart play again. Size up the situation nicely, don't they? However, so the point has gone to the Japanese pair here.
So there's a net touch called on the Dutch, and they're just having a discussion on whether they touch the net inside the red and white lines. So there's the net touch. Ooh, outside the aerial, tough call. But they didn't argue too much.
Great block. Ishii, outstanding.
When you see the smile on the Japanese, you know they're back in it. They're starting to look a lot happier. It's a great move, cross-court block.
Time to jump to perfection. Sets it up nicely. They are in sync at the moment. Just 2 points away now from claiming this first set. Van der Vlist and Van Gistel.
So Van der Vlist back to serve. She's been handing jump float serves onto Murakami. Will she continue that approach? Indeed, but too long. No, just feel the Japanese have shifted momentum a wee bit.
This women's final. Hope you're enjoying it live here on Sky Sport, the New Zealand Beach Volleyball Open here at the ASB Tennis Centre in Auckland. And And there's set point now to Van der Vlist and Van Gestel of the Netherlands, and they have dominated the early stages of the set. The latter stage has been quite even, but they've maintained a healthy advantage, which they build up very quickly at the start of the set. Set point now. Van Gestel to serve it out. And Van Gestel had the opportunity to finish it, but she's pushed it.
She almost saw it too early and was too keen to win it. And missed probably the first time in the set on the back of another big serve. But good save for Japan. They're hanging in there.
Windy conditions. Still set point though. This time the Dutch combination receiving. And it's nicely finished by who? By the player who's been the star of the first set, Sophie Van Gestel. 21 points to 14. And they are in the box seat.
Yeah, Sophie Van Gestel just came with the big jump serve. Threw herself around in the backcourt, made herself look like the backcourt demon, and just transitioned and her offense beautifully to overpower the Japanese. Japanese fought back hard at the end of the set. It'll be interesting if they can keep that rhythm going and try and get a lead and see if they can put some pressure on the Dutch. As the teams take a good break, very important to rehydrate. They reckon if you're running around in the sand at 1 hour of exercise, you can lose 2 to 3 liters of water in that period.
Yeah, not surprised. A very physically demanding sport. He's going to be supporting the Japanese pair, Shiratori, in the next men's final. Shiratori and Hasegawa. Of course, we saw Mike Watson wear the Superman cap, didn't we, in the semi-finals. Maybe he's supporting the Kiwis in the next one after all, eh? Point. Gee, they had to work hard to get it.
Sensational rally to start. Both teams scrambling in the backcourt. Look at this dig. And then the Dutch didn't die on it. A touch made. Van der Vlist chasing hard in the sand. Japan in the lead for the first time.
Yes, they are. Good serve that one, didn't it? Swirled in the wind a touch.
And dropped like a balloon on Van Gestel. First time she's made an error on the serve receive.
Japanese make the fast start in the second set.
Sensational start for the Japanese. See where they couldn't put the ball over in a difficult spot. They played it deep. Gave Van der Vlist a lot of work to do to make a defensive play, run it down, and then run and play a shot. And that's a great tactic for the Japanese. They've had a thought. If we're not going to score the point straight away, we're going to make these Dutch girls run around all over the place.
And they have forced the Dutch pair to take their time out, which is interesting. Only 3 love up in the second set, so we're only at 3 points. Interesting decision there by Van Gestel and Van der Vlist to take their time out.
Yeah, the Dutch may be just feeling a bit of pressure. It's the first time they've been behind. And we talked about when pressure comes on, certain things happen. So they just want to take the momentum of the Japanese away, because they know if they get hot, they go, you know, a bit of a streak, it's very hard to stop.
And Ishii and Murakami not done with yet. Remember, they were down a set in their semi-final as well. They lost that one 21-60, made a slow start in that one. Similar here in the final. Can they repeat what happened in that semi-final by fighting back from a set down to win it? Murakami to serve.
Solid play.
Beach volleyball ball there.
Yeah, very solid from Van der Vlister, though. Not quite as clean as the Dutch have been, but off the net, but down the middle was a good decision by Van der Vlister.
Well, get the feeling they're going to come back, aren't they? They're just class, these two.
Tai Murakami down the sideline, hit the top of the tape, but didn't hit the block, and so the ball's gone out. Suddenly it's almost all square again.
That's a lovely touch, Murakami.
Yep, the wrist they've got to play it nice and close to the net, therefore close to the block, but watch your hair get up and just knuckle the ball to the right of the blocker. Lovely shot.
Well, they hand it back. Change of ends, 4 points to three. So that three love lead they enjoyed earlier is now back to 1 point. And just a reminder to Richard that Van der Vlist and Van Gestel, class combination, and there's an ace.
Yeah, super classy on the world level. The start of their season, hopefully for Olympic gold is where they'll be aiming. Lots of super professional teams out there. This is one of the young Dutch teams. Really, Sophie is, who's one of the top players in the world.
Still alive, that is absolutely superb. It's just nicked. Oh, it's wide. I thought it might have just touched the finger there of one of the Dutch players, but they earned the point. And that is just an example. Never give up. You never know when you're going to win a point, Richard.
Indeed. Murakami's made a mistake again. She's just struggling with the big block and the great defense of Van Gestel.
Got that point, the Japanese pen. They needed it too. Remember, they were three love up. So Van der Vlist and Van Gestel before that had won five of the last 6 points.
The Japanese now need a roll. Murakami, the Japanese ninja beach volleyball player, needs to score some points for her team now with a tough serve.
Quick tap over the net, quick tip. Can catch teams on the hop, can't it?
Indeed, and the out-of-structure play from the Dutch is what's breaking down the Japanese. That's pretty good instruction defensively, but second ball plays, unawares, keeps the Japanese guessing.
Wide. And now it's a two-point lead. They've turned a three-point deficit into a two-point lead. They've won seven of the last 9 points. The Dutch pair are on a roll.
Shot from Murakami. That's how she needs to play. A beautiful pass to the net. A lovely setback from her partner. Off the net, nice, plenty of time. She saw the defense set up its routine and was able to hit open sand. You haven't seen many of those plays in this game so far, but that's where the Japanese need to be.
No, they've not been allowed to do that in this match to the frequency that we saw in the previous effort from them in the semifinals. There's an error. Dutch looking like it'd been touched here. They're arguing the case.
And they're having a wee chat.
I'm convinced it was touched by the Japanese pier. They've given it away now, but... Well, 50-50 call.
Just a wee, maybe a little tickler, but how can you call that? You have to have the eye to see that. So,
it'll have been a tough one. And here comes a reminder, I think.
So you're not allowed to talk with the second referee about the call? Okay. So it wasn't a touch, it wasn't a touch on the block at all? Yeah, they're just coming down.
So, referee Luis Paulo making some clarity for the captain, Van Gestel.
Oh, they've got the confusion they were looking for, the Japanese pair.
You can sense the corporate crowd out there really want the Japanese to fight hard here.
It's a great serve, wasn't it? Right down the middle. Another point. Now the momentum switching back to the Japanese combination.
Two aces in a row, which you haven't seen the whole game. They're serving, their float serving starting to work for them. Looks like the breeze is playing a few tricks on the Dutch. Maybe that'll create a bit of doubt.
Oh dear, oh dear. Free point to this pair.
Just as Japan were getting their act together, they make a mistake when they could have got another point.
Van der Vlist and Van Gestel winning that first set, remember, 21-14.
And then easy as you like, Van der Vlist at the net with a big block. Off the roll shot, suddenly we're all square again. Japan need to take all their opportunities because you know the Dutch are going to score some great plays.
Puts it away this time, does Ishii. She enjoys playing beach volleyball.
Yeah, you can tell that they're just happier now, so they're a lot stronger and tighter in this game. A bit more relaxed, playing their game, realizing they need to play their style and play it well.
Gestel this time. Been waiting for that for a little while.
Indeed, the Japanese realizing there was a touch on the block that time. Had to play the ball back on the second, making an easy play for Van Gestel. She'll go high, hard cross court, off the block.
Great play from the Dutch pair. She just overcooked it, Van Gestel.
She can't believe it. She's a bit surprised. No argument, though. She felt all good in rhythm, hit it hard, and just long.
So technical timeout time. 11 points to 10 with that error from Van Gestel. It's the Japanese combination who have it by a single point.
Yeah, they've done well to fight back into this game. Their defense, a couple of blocks, and more importantly, some aces on the serve. It's got them in the lead, but it is on serve. It's a point ahead, but it's not on. It's just on break. So the Dutch will have a chance to side out straight away to even the score up. It'll be interesting how the Japanese handle the pressure down the stretch, as we say. 13 to 18 is crunch time. If they can maintain their lead, they might be good enough to hold on and force the game into a tie break. I know the crowd here will be looking for that.
Yes, they will. And in that tie break, if it goes to a deciding set, 15 is the magical number rather than 21. Got a win by 2 points. Got a little crowd build up here at the ASB Tennis Arena for finals day. Men's final coming up following this one. Sam O'Day and Mike Watson from New Zealand up against Katsuhiro Shiratori and Yoshimi Hasegawa of Japan. Japanese combination, very impressive in their semi-final win. But we focus on the women's final for the meantime.
Little cut shot, baby cut, we call it in the game of beach volleyball. Just off the top of the hands of Miki Ishii. She couldn't turn around and gain control of that ball. They're getting a lot closer to making defensive plays. That's where they need to be. Now they need a strong side out. This is going to Murakami. She needs to make a good pass.
It's good play from the Japanese pair. They set up the point beautifully.
In the game of beach volleyball, it's all about that first pass. Putting it in the same spot all the time for your partner to set you up accurately. The Japanese struggled with it in the first set. We've got their rhythm here in the second.
Fabulous defense mid-rally. Could it be converted by the Japanese pair? Just the power coming through again from the Dutch pair.
Yeah, the first dig from the heap from Murakami is a good one, but Sophie Van Gistel gets a second chance, goes the high line, and it's just high enough to beat Ishii down the line.
Even the super quick reactions of Vandevlis could get that one done.
Yeah, Murakami and Ishii know they were lucky on that play. Murakami straight into the block of Vandevlis, but she couldn't control it. A lucky but good point for the Japanese. They maintain their lead.
They're hanging tough. Nice change up that time from Vandevlist.
Looked like the Cobra played, which is out reach with the hands together, fingers tight, hard, and hand forming the shape of a Cobra.
Oh, that's beautifully finished. Ishii can turn it on when she wants to.
Excuse me. Weird net touch.
Touch the line there, touch the net maybe.
Yeah, she followed through and hit the top of the tape. She knows she did. A big point missed actually.
So that one went to the Netherlands.
And then Vandevlist with the shutout block and 3 points in a row has taken the Dutch team into a convincing run.
15-13. This is getting tight now for the Japanese pair. Sweating on that one, and it's wide. Dear, oh dear. Timeout's been called by the Japanese pair. Critical time. That play right there might come back to haunt them.
Yeah, they've just run out of steam at the clutch time. 4 points in a row. A couple of great plays by the Dutch side, but also a couple of misplays by the Japanese. That's the pressure of the situation. They were playing so well, were so happy and comfortable in the lead, but suddenly the big blocking of Vandevlis and the hustle in the backcourt by Van Gistel means they've scored 4 quick points and the game has just been taken away from the Japanese.
16-13, remember they were up by 3 points at one stage, that Japanese pair. Now they trail by three at a critical time of the match. Remember they lost that first set 14-21. Must win this set to take it through to a decider otherwise. it's going to be the Netherlands who will be celebrating as champions. Expert play again from Ishii.
Lovely cut shot into open sand. Variation of the play. Never seen that one too often today. And they made it look easy. 14 points to 16. The tough serves required. Murakami.
Oh, the bump there, the dig no good there at all from Van der Blist.
Yeah, she's missed another one. You'd call that an ace on the back of a tough serve for Murakami, and it keeps the Japanese alive. Can they get another one?
And this time, Van der Blist has it. She's just too big. Oh, poor Murakami there. Fashy hit it into the net as much as her opponent.
Yeah, Murakami, super disappointed with that play. Did everything right and then tried to hit it too hard instead of placing it into one of the open spaces. Big point.
Well, these are big points now for the Japanese pair. 3 points away from the match, Van der Blist and Van Gestel. 3 points away from match point, that is, so far. And there is the expert finish from Van der Blist.
Lovely cut shot. The defense was set up well by the Japanese. A nice deep serve to the middle of the court. Van der Blist was under pressure. Saw the cross block, saw the line defender, so played the ball into the cross space. Swing is good from Murakami. Lovely shot. So they hang in there, Japanese. They go to what we think is the weaker end just because of the breeze at the moment. So they need to make a defensive play. Murakami, tough server. What can she do?
Van der Blist gets it in. Again, it's reaching the point where it's going to take something very special from this Japanese pair now. Even though they're only down by 2 points. Van der Blist, Van Gestel, the match is in their hands, isn't it?
Yes, indeed. Lovely serve from Murakami, but not quite enough to create an error from the Dutch this time.
Gestel with the big serve. And the finish. Decisive play comes again from Van Gestel.
Beautiful big serve. The Japanese tried to run a play off it, but in the end just gave a free ball over the net to the Dutch. And here we go, ladies and gentlemen, match point.
That's it. It's Van der Blist who's got it done. The New Zealand Beach Volleyball Open title in the women's has gone to Sophie Van Gestel and Jantien Van der Blist of the Netherlands, who have completed a 21-14, 21-17 win. Too classy, too big, too strong for the Japanese pair. Success here in New Zealand for the Netherlands.
Well, they add to a classy list of champions of the New Zealand Open. We've had some of the best beach volleyballers in the world win the New Zealand women's title over the last 15 years. And there we have a new champion, a new country champion of our New Zealand Open title, the Dutch team. Sensational performance, just too big and strong for the Japanese today. But they were sensational in their semi-final and fought hard in that second set to come back a little. But in the end, not quite good enough.
And who knows, this pair might be making a splash at Rio 2016 this year. Sophie Van Gestel, who's on the right of shot there, an Olympian from 2012 in London, just missed the quarterfinals.
Yeah, that's Paul Cameron down there, the CEO of Volleyball New Zealand, taking the photo of the officials and the teams in the final. Good work. The old CEO loves it. Very passionate about the game.
So there we are. The women's final is done here at the New Zealand Beach Volleyball Open, and it is victory to the Netherlands over Miki Ishii and Megumi Murakami of Japan. The final score, 21-14, 21-17. Let's have a look at some highlights, Richard Kasut. And it was early on, it was the Dutch who were really dominating this match.
Indeed, they just came out, all guns blazing, big serves, great scramble in the backcourt. Japan struggled to get some side outs, and they had to be cheeky to get them. But the power at the net from the Dutch was too much in the end. Japan fought hard, made some great defensive plays, forced a bit of scramble from the Dutch. But in the end, the big hitting from the Dutch created too much pressure for the Japan team to keep playing their lovely little shots. You saw the highlights of them there, but that was probably it for most of the game. Then they got a few ace serves to keep themselves in it in that second set. And you actually saw them smile for a while.
Yeah, they fought well, Japan, though, but you always had the feeling this pair here were just a count or two above their Japanese opponents in all aspects, including defense and blocking, which we saw there from Vanderblist. But Murakami and Ishii, they tried their best to really hang tough. But in the end, just too good, the pair from the Netherlands. So final score again, 21-14. 21-17. So there we are, the women's is all done. We're standing by now for the final of the men's, which is going to be a battle between New Zealand and Japan. Sam O'Day, Mike Watson.